March is over, no more snow, spring is here, and it's time for another edition of Double Up, Buy Once, or Pass. The concept is simple. I'm going to go over the sneaker releases of April 2023. If I love a shoe, I'm going to give it a double up. If I like but don't love the shoe, I'm going to give it a buy once and pass. Pass is self-explanatory. Disclaimer, I couldn't include every single shoe dropping in April 2023. We'd be here until May, so I chose shoes that I thought were interesting, that I had an opinion on. Here we go. First up is the Air Jordan 11 Low Cement Gray, which is releasing on April 1st for $190. This is a new colorway on the Jordan 11 Lows. This is a very simple colorway. Of course, you see that patent leather, a very distinct feature of the Jordan 11. I especially love the soles, the translucent icy soles. Love that. And the Jordan 11 has always been a very comfortable shoe for my wide feet. It's really hard to go wrong with a colorway as simple and as neutral as this one. However, I've never really been a big fan of the Jordan 11 Lows. There's just something about how it looks. I think it's too chunky to make it a low. The Jordan 11 in the normal form, I feel like there's just enough ankle to kind of offset that more chunky, bulkier look of the silhouette. Also, on top of that, I don't love patent leather. Even though the Jordan 11s have been a very comfortable shoe for my feet, right now it's just not a shoe that I need. Generally, I stay clear of Jordan 11 Lows. So unfortunately, starting this list off on a low, giving this shoe a pass. Next up, I'm going to talk about two shoes together because it's the same colorway, just a different silhouette. And that's the Nike Air Force 1 Low and the Nike Dunk Low ATL. These are dropping on April 6th for $130 for the Air Force 1 and $120 for the Nike Dunk. Now, this is a continuation of Nike's celebration of the 50th year of hip hop. And the very prominent red on both these shoes is meant to resemble the hot as fire rise of Atlanta's dominance in hip hop. Both these shoes feature an all suede upper sole as well as a crimson swoosh and the words ATL debossed in gold on the heel. And according to Nike.com, it's meant to represent that the South owns the crown of hip hop. And I really, really dig this colorway. I love red shoes in general. I love the Air Force One. It's one of my favorite silhouettes. However, I don't love the Nike Dunks. It takes a lot for me to go and actually buy a Nike Dunk, even though all things considered, they are a relatively cheap shoe. However, this colorway has really got me going. I think I'm gonna give it a buy once for both. Next up is a collaboration between Uninterrupted and the Nike LeBron 20, dubbed Speak Your Truth. Uninterrupted is a company founded by LeBron James and his business partner and longtime friend Maverick Carter, which is a company focused on player and athlete empowerment. The last few collaborations between Uninterrupted and LeBron has been fire in my opinion. There was the LeBron 17 More Than an Athlete that dropped in 2017 and the Nike Air Force 1 in 2019. I love that shoe. And I think this shoe, even though I generally don't love LeBron 20s, especially that double swoosh, the details on this shoe are just phenomenal. There's uninterrupted tabs on the heel as well as the logo debossed on the side of the shoe. And on one outsole it says speak, the other outsole it says truth. And I love that font, that looks dope. And on the midsole you can see the words uninterrupted all over. I don't love that heavy use of sail on the midsole. I think it would have looked cleaner with just a white midsole. However, all the details and the colorway of the shoe overall, I'm really digging it. I don't actually own any LeBron 20s. I've never owned a pair of LeBron 20s, but I think I gotta give this shoe a buy once. Also dropping on April 6th for $120 is a Nike Dunk Low Pink Foam. This shoe features an all suede upper sole with pink overlays with black and white laces, which Nike.com describes as mesmerizing. Now, I don't know about all that, but I can see it's black and white. As I said before, it takes a lot for me to actually buy a Nike Dunk. So unless it's a colorway I really, really love, I don't really give it a second thought. And this colorway, even though it's clean, it's pretty nice. I don't think I can pull it off very well. I'm definitely giving this shoe a pass. Now, I don't know if this is a hot take, it's just my opinion. They should just get rid of all non-SB Dunks. I think just go with SB Dunks in the future. People tend to like them more anyway, so why saturate the market with all these non-SB Dunks? I don't know, it's not for me. Next up, releasing on April 7th for $240, is the Nike Air Foamposite White and Black. Nike seems to really be pushing the Foamposites this year. We've already seen the Dream a World series, the Tech Gray and the Black version that's coming out at the end of March. And we've also seen official images of the metallic red Foamposites. Now this one, I think this is my favorite Foamposites in a while. This shoe was originally a player exclusive for Penny Hardaway in 1997. He first wore this colorway in a game against the Bulls. And I think it's just such a clean colorway. That white and that Foamposite material with the black offset, whew, it is dope. It is very, very dope. Now one major change that they made to this shoe, usually on the eyelets, it's made out of nubuck, but they changed this one to leather. Now I've seen a lot of people complain that it's not a one-to-one of the OG, but as someone that prefers leather material over pretty much anything else, I really like that change. I think it looks better. that is what it is. Two complaints I've always had of the foam posits were the mini swoosh at the toe box, as well as the double pull tabs. I feel like two pull tabs is just one too many. I only need one, but there's a pretty little details. I'm willing to overlook them for this clean colorway. I'm definitely giving this shoe a buy once. I don't really know if Nike's strategy of pushing the foam posits in 2023 will see a resurgence of the foam posits back to like 2012 foam posit galaxy level hype, but that's good news for me. I've never really loved the foam posits, but I do like them in general. I generally like most colorways, so the easier it is to get for me, the better. Also dropping on April 7th for $120 is Jason Tatum's first signature shoe, the Jordan Tatum 1 Zoo. Initially, when this shoe first was leaked, people poked a lot of fun at the silhouette. It was not appealing. It was getting trashed so much that Tatum had to come out and say that's not actually his shoe. However, it does seem like people have turned the corner. I see a lot more positive comments about the shoe, especially with more colorways coming out. But I really don't like this shoe. I think that TPU reinforced frame throughout the shoe, I think there's just too much. It's too prominent. You see it comes all the way up into the mid panel, which I guess makes it a very distinguishing feature of the shoe, but I don't like it. I don't know if it'll start to grow on me, and the more I see it, the more I like it. But as of right now, I really, really don't like this shoe. Now, it has the name Zoo because it was inspired by his son's favorite place to visit, which is the zoo. So you'll see on the heel counter, giraffe, zebra, and cat prints are very prominent. And you also see Jason Tatum's logo on the tongue. I do think it's cool that Tatum really dedicates everything to his son. You see he's always featured on post-game interviews. He really just enjoys to be around his son, which I think is dope. But as wholesome as that is, I gotta give this shoe a pass. Next up is the Air Jordan 2 Craft Atmosphere that's releasing on April 8th for $150. This is yet another Jordan 2 in 2023 and another shoe in the Craft collection. At this point, I don't even really know what the definition of craft is anymore. This Jordan 2 has a very unique upper sole. It's made out of seersucker material on the forefoot as well as the tongue. And on the heel, it's made out of gingham material. And the pattern and the colorway is very, very unique. The prominent use of pink as well as that peachy, orangey, vanilla accent kind of reminds me of candy or candy floss. And while I'm not a big fan of the pattern and the material that's used on the upper sole, I think the colorway is enough for me to overlook that. I think it's very cool. It's kind of pastel, which I really like. It's kind of subtle, but also stands out in a lot of ways. So I'm gonna give this shoe a buy once. And I'm starting to realize that I'm racking up the Jordan 2s in my collection. So I guess Jordan Brand's strategy of over-promoting the Jordan 2 in 2023 is working. At least it's working for this idiot. Also dropping on April 8th for $180 is the Air Jordan 1 Skyline. Now this shoe was supposed to drop in March. I included it in the March edition of Double Up Buy Once or Pass. Unfortunately, April 8th, it's still not confirmed by Jordan Brand. So cross my fingers, I hope it comes out this month. But I'm gonna go over it again. This shoe obviously inspired by the very famous photograph of Jordan doing the Jumpman logo pose on a backdrop of Chicago skyline. Very, very iconic photo. The colorway is obviously very, very unique. However, just like a month ago, I don't love the denim overlays on the shoe. I also don't like the sale midsole. I think I'm officially at the point where I am sick of sale midsoles. I'm just sick of it. Give me white midsoles, give me something else, anything but sale midsoles. Despite all of that, I think it's a very dope colorway. I think it's very special. Air Jordan 1 is obviously one of the best silhouettes out there. I gotta give this shoe a buy once. Next up is the Nike Dunk Low Setsuban, releasing on April 11th for $120. I don't know if I pronounced that correctly, I can't speak Japanese, so apologies to anyone that can. But this shoe was inspired by the Setsuban Festival, which is a bean throwing festival in Japan, celebrated on the day before spring every year. Now the bean throwing is meant to chase away demons and get rid of bad spirits. Now the upper sole of the shoe features shades of brown and a crack leather texture, as well as a purple swoosh. And you see a demon on the heel. I think it's a very dope colorway. It's very different. The brown is kind of a great shoe for old men like myself. And the dopest thing about this shoe are the insoles. It is artwork made by the artist Kuniyoshi, depicting the demon slaying warrior that's in Japanese folklore. As someone that has a full Japanese sleeve, I obviously love Japanese inspired artwork. And despite not being a big Dunks fan, this is the second Dunk on this list that I'm gonna have to give a buy once. Next up is the Air Max 1 Concept Japan Michigan. The shoe is releasing on April 14th for $160. Now, I don't think the release date is confirmed yet, but I'm crossing every finger, every toe for this shoe to release and for me to get a win. This might be my favorite shoe on the list. I don't care what anyone says. I love the Air Max 1. It's my favorite Air Max. I love the Michigan Wolverines colorway. Concept Japan, if you didn't know, was a line made by Nike for Japanese retailers. But as the years went on, it was so popular, it's kind of just expanded all over the world. Now, Concept Japan is written as co.jp, which was the URL for Japan Nike. The shoe features a navy-based leather layer with a reptile faux lizard skin texture on the mudguard and snakeskin on the swoosh. A mini swoosh is also added near the toe box. Now, usually this shoe features three things I don't love. A mini swoosh, faux lizard skin texture, as well as snakeskin. I don't like those things in isolation, but for some reason, on this shoe, on this colorway, it's got me. I love this. I love this shoe so much. I can't put my finger on it. It's indescribable. It's intangible. But I'm definitely giving this shoe a double up, double up, double up. Next up is the Air Jordan 1 Lucky Green that's dropping on April 15th for $180. This shoe originally dropped in 2009 as part of the DMP pack. And the Lucky Green is supposed to reference the 63-point game that MJ had against the Celtics way back in his younger days. They still lost the game, but after the game, Larry Bird famously said, "That's God disguised as Michael Jordan." Overall, I like this colorway. I actually made a review of the Air Jordan 1 Lucky Green Lows, and I pretty much got that shoe by accident. I was scrolling Finish Line and saw the shoe and said, why not? I can make a review on it. But I didn't really need that shoe. And in person, that Lucky Green on a shoe, it's a bit brighter than I would like, especially on that leather material. However, on the low version of that shoe, because the base layer is black, I think that green maybe stands out a bit more. On this shoe, because the base layer is white, I think the green might not look as bright as the low version. That's what I'm hoping anyway, because I do like this colorway. I think it's a clean shoe. Love the Jordan 1s. I think I'm going to give this shoe a buy once. Next up is a women's exclusive dropping on April 22nd for $180, the Air Jordan 1 Washed Pink. This is one of my favorite shoes on this list. I really like that pink colorway, and the sale midsole I think actually works for this shoe. The pink is kind of made to look like a vintage pink, a kind of more distressed pink if you will. So that sale midsole as well as the off-white ankle color, that actually makes sense for this shoe specifically. I don't think that April 22nd release date is confirmed, but again, crossing my fingers, crossing my toes, it drops. This shoe consists of a white base leather layer with pink suede overlays. It's so neutral, it's muted, but it's also very different. Love this colorway, can't say enough about it. There's something about this shoe, it's just so pleasing to the eye. So I'm gonna give this shoe a double up. Also dropping on April 22nd for $200 is the Air Jordan 13 Black Flint. This is about as simple as a colorway can actually get. Black, gray, white, or technically not colors. This is just like the Jordan 13 Flints, but instead of the blue, they swap it out with a black mesh overlay, as well as white base leather layer and suede mudguard, as well as the heel. Of course, it features the very distinct Jordan 23 hologram on the heel, as well as a Phylon midsole. And one of the most pleasantly surprising things about a Jordan 13 is how light it is. In a vacuum, it looks heavy and bulky, but it's super lightweight. The padding inside is so good. It feels so comfortable on my feet. I love the comfort and feel of the Jordan 13s, but I don't love the silhouette overall. I don't think it's a very versatile shoe. So like, but don't love. I'm giving this shoe a buy once. Next up on April 26th is the Air Jordan 1 Low OG Travis Scott Olive. Every month when I make this list, there's always one shoe that I think will break the sneakers app or the internet. Last month it was the Air Jordan 3 Reimagined, and this month, this shoe might be it. Every Jordan brand Travis Scott collaboration is bound to sell out. Even the probably least popular Travis Scott Jordan, the Jordan 1 Phantoms, those sold out pretty much instantly. And generally, honestly, I don't love Travis Scott collaborations as much as the general population that are into sneakers. I don't really like the reverse swoosh. I don't really listen to his music. I'm kind of an old man in that sense, where 95% of the music I listen to nowadays is hip hop from days when I was growing up. So no disrespect to Travis Scott. He's just kind of part of that next generation. And this colorway is packing some heat. I love olive. It's one of my favorite colors. Definitely my favorite shade of green. I have a lot of olive clothing. Now the shoe features a black suede base layer with white leather overlays. And thank God it is an Air Jordan 1 Low OG, so the tongue is not long and weird like the non-OG Jordan 1 Lows. Obviously, Cactus Jack can be seen on the tongue and the insole. And damn, this colorway is just so dope. That olive green just hits different. It's probably my favorite Travis Scott collaboration ever. So I'm definitely gonna give this shoe a double up. Finally dropping on April 29 for $210 is the Air Jordan 3 Wizards. Now this colorway is based on the Wizards of the early 2000s when Michael Jordan was part of the team. And at first glance, it kind of looks like an Air Jordan 3 True Blue. However, the shade of blue is lighter, and on the tongue, the Jumpman is gold as opposed to a red Jumpman. And just a tangent, remember those gold jerseys that the Wizards had back in the day? I remember watching Gilbert Arenas drop 60 points on Kobe Bryant wearing that gold jersey. So dope, so sick. They need to bring those back just for a game or two. old people like myself. But this colorway in general, I think it's pretty average. Nothing too special about it. It's a blue and white shoe. However, it's just really, really, really hard to say no to a Jordan 3. It's such a versatile silhouette. It's so comfortable on my feet. So despite the very mediocre and average colorway, in my opinion, I'm gonna give this shoe a buy once. So that's it. Let me know what shoes you would definitely double up on from this list. Thanks for watching Soul Inclined. Like, subscribe, comment, all the good stuff. And remember, tomorrow may never come, so wear your shoes.